In this video, we're going to talk about the 80-20 rule and how to apply that to being a musician. So if you're excited, hit the like button, subscribe, and let's get into it. My name is Lydia Walker from RusticSongbird.com, and I'm fascinated by understanding why we do what we do. As a musician and a songwriter, I'm always thinking about what can I do next, what can I do to be more effective, more productive, and especially as a mom of two little kids, my time is precious now more than ever, and so I want to make the most impact with my music while I can, while I have the time to work on it in those little time chunks. So the 80-20 rule, or it's also called the Pareto principle, is all about the theory that roughly 80% of any result comes from 20% of causes. And how this applies is that you can literally audit your time or audit your efforts and see that 80% of your results comes from 20% of the work that you do. And so when we really get specific and look at those things that are causing the biggest needle movers, causing the biggest results or the biggest success, it really comes down to that 20%. So how do we find the 20% that makes the most revenue, that makes the most sales, that makes the most impact? It's really important to audit what we're doing and not just do busy work for the sake of it, but realize what was the cause that led to that result. And if we can focus on doing more of the things in that 20% range, then we're going to be able to scale and do bigger things, make bigger impacts, impact more people, impact more lives. And so as musicians, I think we have amazing opportunities to use music to inspire people, to bring them hope. And what better way to, you know, figure out what's working and then do more of that. So with the 80-20 rule, we can look at how 80% of our results come from 20% of our work. And I want to share some specific examples. If you're trying to wrap your head around this idea and trying to really figure out, like, how can I use this theory, this principle for myself and for my own success? So as a musician, you may notice that 20% of your songs are the most popular, even though you wrote lots of songs. Only a few of those songs will become pretty popular, and the ones that people request, the ones that people download the most. And if you're putting out cover videos or making videos for your songs, probably 20% of those videos are going to do really well, and the other 80% may not do so well. But it's looking at those things, looking at the data, the analytics, looking at why things are working, and then figuring out what are the themes and what are the patterns and what were the things that I specifically did for those that I didn't do for the other 80%. And what if we could figure out that little formula or those patterns and then amplify it, do more like that? For instance, on my YouTube channel, I've posted a lot of different types of things because I have a lot of different interests. So I might post a video tutorial of playing a song on guitar, or I might do a guitar review. And what I've realized is that when I do a guitar video, those tend to do really well on my channel. So I know if I make another guitar video, it's probably going to do well. And what I've noticed with my music that I've written and recorded and put out there, there's several songs that keep getting requested over and over and over. And if I look at the downloads and the streams from my music as a musician, I can see there's a top three songs that are doing really, really well, and then the others get a few streams. And so that's just how it is. But also with gigs, I've noticed when I play lots of gigs, there might be one gig that has a really good turnout or really good sales, or I meet somebody there that's a great connection for another gig in the future. And sometimes you don't know what the difference is. So when you're starting out and you don't have that data and you don't have that experience to look back on, it's good to experiment, it's good to test, it's good to try things and then look back and say, okay, what were the top 10 gigs last year that I did? You know, what were the highest paying gigs? What was the best crowd? Which ones did we sell the most merch? Or as a songwriter, if you see, okay, which songs out of all these songs I've written over the past year, over the past, I don't know, 10 years, if you've been writing for a long time like me, what are the songs that really resonate with people and why is that, and how can I do more of what's working? And so just understanding this concept, I think, helps us to put things in perspective, and then we're not so hard on ourselves thinking that every song that we write should be a hit song and everything that we put out, every video that we put out should be going viral. It's just not how the world works. It's not how this principle works. And so what if we could flip that 80-20? What if we could focus on the 20% of things that make the most impact, and then that becomes our 80%. We're focusing 80% of our time on the 20% of things that are working. That's really when you find the sweet spot and when things blow up, because you're focused, because you are specific, because you look into the details, figure out what's working. What are people asking for? I think that was a huge aha moment for me, because I used to write songs and try to figure out what my sound was and, you know, what was my message and blah, blah, blah. But I realized it's not about me. I need to be listening to what the audience wants and see what they're relating to, what they're resonating with, and then give them more of that. If you're serving people that way, they're gonna keep coming back. They're gonna buy whatever you come out with because you're making it for them from your perspective and from your style, but then you're not having to create a market for it. The market's already there. And so one thing that I've learned about driving traffic to things, whether it's getting more views on your videos or getting more streams for your music or getting more butts in the seats for a show, when you are driving traffic for something, people want to connect with an emotion. They don't really care how popular you are. They don't really care, you know, how cool you are. They care about how the music makes them feel, and they care about what your message does for them. And so if you can connect with that one person, you can connect with so many other people. So I think the importance is paying attention to what's going on and realizing that it's not about you, and realizing that if you serve that one person and connect with that one person, you do that over and over and over again. You serve that one person really well, they're gonna remember that for the rest of their life, and then they become a true fan. You may have heard the concept of 1,000 true fans. If you had 1,000 true fans who would just come to every show, who would buy every CD you come out with, who would stream your music, who would recommend it to a friend, those true fans, then you wouldn't need any more than 1,000 true fans for your entire career, because they will support whatever you're coming out with. And so I think when we look at the top musicians and the artists out there that are getting millions of plays and millions of streams, it just seems unattainable. But if we realize that success for ourselves could look differently, it could be 1,000 true fans. It could be one great song that goes out there and connects with lots of people. It doesn't have to be hit after hit after hit. But if we realize what's making a splash, what's making a difference, and then putting out more of that, people are going to continue to connect with our music. And so as a songwriter, as a musician, trying to figure out what are those 20% that's making the 80% impact, and how can I focus on doing more of that? So that's my encouragement for you today, is to think about how you're spending your time and what can you cut out that could free up more time to do what's actually making the difference. There's a lot of busy work out there. You could be out there just doing a little bit of everything, throwing spaghetti at the wall. There is a time for that, for testing things to see if it's working. But at some point, and if you're watching this, you might be ready. At some point, you got to get specific with why you're doing this. You got to get specific with how you're going to do it and what you're going to do with the time that you have. And so this is the best time to be an independent musician, to be putting music out there, because we have the internet and we have these free platforms like YouTube, and we can put our music out there on Spotify and on iTunes and build our own following. And so there's so much opportunity, and I will keep encouraging you to put yourself out there, put your songs out there, because the world needs to hear them. And I believe every voice is unique and you have something special to bring to the table, and there is a seat at the table for you. I want to encourage you to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this coming soon. I'm so excited to share what I'm learning about the music industry and what has worked for me, what I've seen work for others. And also, I want to invite you to check out the Rustic Songbird podcast. It's a weekly podcast where I interview people in the music industry and share their stories, share their tips and advice, and especially encouragement, because I know you've got all the talent inside of you that you need to succeed, but you might feel discouraged, or you might feel lonely, or you just need that support and that community. That's what Rustic Songbird's all about, and I've made this with you in mind. So check out the Rustic Songbird podcast. There are a ton of episodes already where you can go binge listen. Listen to them all. They're all so, so good, and I'm excited to bring you more episodes every single Monday. So go check out rusticsongbird.com/podcast for the whole list of episodes, or you can check it out in your podcast app by searching Rustic Songbird. Let me know in the comments if this idea of the 80-20 rule sparked something in you. Let me know what questions you have about that. And also, what other questions do you have about marketing and promoting your music and getting it out there? Because I really want to help you find a way to bring your music to the next level and get it out to those raving fans. So thank you for watching this video. Remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Tap that notification bell and you'll be notified when I have a new video coming out. And there will be new videos like this coming soon. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one.